It's October of 2022. Should I update to Windows 11 now? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. This is a periodic update to an article I have called Should I Upgrade to Windows 11? The reason, of course, is that the answer will eventually change. The answer will eventually be yes, you should. But you can imply from what I just said, that today's answer is no. There's really not necessarily a reason to proactively upgrade your working Windows 10 machine to Windows 11. It's been out for a year now, and it's a fine operating system. Don't get me wrong. I'm not saying you need to avoid it, but it's one of those things where there's just no real compelling reason for someone with a working Windows 10 machine to upgrade to Windows 11. Someday there will be. Someday, if nothing else, Windows 10 will end its support in 2025, 3 years from now. But right now, today, if you've got a working Windows 10 machine, there's really nothing that compelling to say you should upgrade to Windows 11. There are a couple of maybe you shouldn't. One of the issues with Windows 11 that seems to have at least confused its release, although it seems to be settling down, are the system requirements. Some of the systems that are currently running Windows 10 supposedly cannot run Windows 11. They don't meet the hardware requirements. Even there are apparently workarounds that can force a so-called incompatible machine to install Windows 11. What does that mean for the long term on that machine? We don't know. It's very possible that at some point Microsoft could further enforce the hardware requirements and that Windows 11 machine could suddenly start failing or start throwing errors, or who knows. The other side is also possible, that it's very possible that because the hardware requirements seem a little bit onerous, they could be relaxed. We don't know. Not something necessarily worth playing around with unless you've got some other ulterior motive, some reason. Again, if you're working in Windows 10, then fine. Keep working in Windows 10. The other thing that has caused some amount of confusion and, in, I'll just say, annoyance among some of the Windows 11 upgrades that have happened in the last year is that Microsoft has played with the taskbar, the start menu, again. I remember that with Windows 8, there was a huge uproar when they made the changes there. Windows 10, they kind of reeled it back in again. Windows 11, they've made some more changes and in fact removed some interesting functionality from the taskbar that a number of people are, I'll just say, concerned by. Some people don't notice. If these are features you don't use, like moving the taskbar to the side of the screen, for example, then you wouldn't know that there's a difference. But it is something that has changed, and it's not a huge controversy, but it's probably the most controversial piece of Windows 11 next to the hardware requirement. So that's another reason to maybe hold off to see if at some point they bring more features and functionality back to the taskbar and make it a little bit of an easier transition sometime in the future. Now, there's something that I'm hesitant to mention, but I mention it anyway, and that is what we call the every other version curse. Here's how it works. Windows XP, very popular. Windows Vista, not so much. Windows 7, quite popular. Windows 8 and 8.1, again, not so much. Windows 10, over a billion installations around the planet. Extremely popular, perhaps the most popular version of Windows ever. Windows 11? We just don't know. But it's on the side of, well, maybe it's not going to be quite as popular. Again, that's not a reason to not upgrade, but it is one more thing to keep in mind. Maybe bide your time. The bottom line is that if you don't know, if you are running Windows 10, and you're happy with Windows 10, it's working for you on your machine, then great. Stick with Windows 10. My recommendation today, October 2022, don't bother upgrading to Windows 11. Now, the one thing I am adding with this update is simply this. If you get a new machine and that new machine comes with Windows 11 pre-installed, great. There's no reason to avoid Windows 11 either. Windows 11, like I said, it's a fine operating system. I'm running it here on my main machine. I recently upgraded my laptop to it. There have just been no issues really with Windows 11 that would cause me to say you should avoid it. The issue is that there's just nothing that compelling for you to go through the work of taking a working machine and upgrading it to Windows 11. But if it comes with Windows 11, a brand new machine coming with Windows 11, by all means, run Windows 11 and enjoy it. It's, like I said, it's not a bad operating system. It's essentially what I've referred to as a service pack to Windows 10. Hope that helps you make the decision. Like I said, in most cases, the decision is, keep waiting unless you have a reason not to. For comments, for updates, for related links and more, visit askleo.com/135037. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.